probably heard things like just eat less and move more, or that carbohydrates make you fat. But how much of that is actually true? As a weight loss specialist, I've seen patients frustrated by the same myth over and over again. Today, let's separate facts from fiction and find out what really works. Hi, I'm Dr. Basra Khalid, and I'm a board-certified obesity medicine and internal medicine doctor. As a weight loss specialist, I've seen how common myths can derail even the most motivated people. So today, let's cut through the noise by breaking down the top weight loss myths and talk about the science-backed truth to help you lose fat the right way and protect your long-term health. Trust me, you don't want to miss number 7. You need to eat very few calories to lose weight. Crash diets may give quick results, but at a cost. You lose muscle, slow your metabolism, and increase your risk for weight regain. While creating a caloric deficit is essential for weight loss, drastically cutting calories can backfire. It leads to muscle loss, hormonal disruption, and metabolic slowdown. Your body perceives extreme caloric restriction as a threat and shifts into conservation mode. Fact is, you need a moderate calorie deficit, typically 500 to 700 calories less than maintenance, not starvation. Combine that with protein and resistance training for sustainable results. People who eat too little for too long burn fewer calories at rest, even when they are not dieting anymore. Carbohydrates are the enemy. Not all carbohydrates are bad. Yes, ultra-processed carbohydrates spike blood sugar, but whole carbohydrates like legumes, oats, vegetables can actually support weight loss by fueling workouts and providing fiber. Carbohydrates are often blamed for weight gain, but we need to remember that not all carbohydrates are created equal. Refined carbohydrates like white bread, pastries, and sugary drinks do spike insulin and hunger. However, whole carbohydrates like vegetables, fruits, legumes, and whole grains are nutrient dense and help regulate appetite and energy. Fact is, you do not need to eliminate all carbohydrates. Instead, prioritize high fiber, low glycemic carbohydrates and pair them with protein and healthy fats for better blood sugar control. Fiber-rich carbohydrates feed your gut bacteria, which may help regulate appetite and inflammation. You have to do cardio to lose weight. Cardio burns calories, but it's not the most efficient way to lose weight. Strength training helps preserve muscle mass, boosts resting metabolism, and reshapes your body. Cardio burns calories in the short term, but resistance training builds muscle, which boosts your resting metabolism. Muscle tissue burns more energy than fat, even at rest. Fact is, a combination of strength training and some cardio is optimal. Prioritize muscle preserving workouts. Again, the fact is muscle burns more calories at rest than fat, helping you lose weight even when resting or even sitting. If the scale isn't moving, you're failing. Scale weight can fluctuate due to water, hormones, even digestion. Scale weight includes fat, muscle, water, food in your system, and more. It fluctuates daily based on hydration, hormones, digestion, and sleep. Fact is, track your progress using multiple tools. Body measurements, maybe progress photos, strength benchmarks, how clothes fit, or better yet, body composition tools like DEXA, not just the number on the scale. Eating late at night causes weight gain because metabolism slows down. Many people believe that if you eat, let's say after 7 or 8 p.m., your body won't burn those calories properly and you will store them as fat. This idea comes from the thought that metabolism shuts down or slows significantly at night. Fact is, weight gain depends primarily on total calories consumed versus calories burned, not the specific timing of meals. Total calories and food quality matter far more than timing. Late eating can affect digestion and sleep, but it won't automatically cause fat gain. The time you eat matters far less than what and how much you eat. Your body doesn't automatically store food as fat at after a certain hour. Scientific studies show that metabolism doesn't shut down at night. Your body continuously burns calories 24/7. What matters most for weight gain or weight loss is your overall energy balance over the entire day or week. Eating late won't cause weight gain if your total calorie intake is appropriate. However, late night eating can sometimes lead to excess calorie intake or poor food choices, which may indirectly contribute to weight gain. A 2020 study found no consistent link between meal timing and fat gain, just total calorie balance. Fasting guarantees fat loss. Intermittent fasting can help some people eat less, but it's not magic. If you overeat during your eating window or undereat protein, you may lose muscle rather than fat. Intermittent fasting can help reduce caloric intake by limiting your eating window. However, if your meals are unbalanced or you undereat protein, fasting may lead to muscle loss. The fact is, fasting is a tool, not a magic bullet. Nutrient timing and quality are still key. GLP-1 medications make diet and exercise irrelevant. GLP-1 medications like Wegovy and Zepbound, Ozempic and Mounjaro can reduce hunger. But if you're not getting enough protein or doing resistance training, you'll lose muscle too. Medications help, but they don't replace lifestyle. GLP-1 medications happen to be a very effective tool combined with the right lifestyle to get a better, healthier, and stronger version of yourself. Fact is, medications assist your effort as a tool. They don't replace them. Lifestyle habits remain essential. You can spot reduce fat. Sorry, but doing 100 crunches won't burn belly fat. Fat loss occurs systemically. You cannot target a specific area. Crunches don't burn belly fat. Fact is, fat comes off where your body decides. Focus on total body fat reduction through a balanced diet and strength training. Fat loss happens systemically throughout the body. Your genetics decides where it comes off first. Supplements will fix everything. No supplement will replace sleep, nutrition, and movement. While certain supplements like protein powder, creatine, vitamin D can support your goals, but they don't overcome a poor diet or lack of exercise. The fact is, think of supplements as enhancement to a solid foundation, not the foundation itself. You should be losing weight every week. Fat loss is not linear. Factors like water retention, hormone changes, especially in women, and stress can stall the scale temporarily. You'll have weeks where the scale stalls or even goes up due to water retention. Consistency wins over time, not perfection. Fact is, plateaus are normal. Focus on consistency and long-term patterns, not week-to-week changes. Consistency over perfection. The truth is, there is a lot of noise out there, and not all of that is helpful. Weight loss is neither simple nor easy, and believing the wrong myths can derail your progress before you even start. Remember, weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's about your metabolism, your hormones, your strength, and your long-term health. Stick with the facts, support your body with protein, strength training, sleep and mindset, and you'll get the results that will last. Which myth surprised you the most? Drop it in the comments. If you want to go deeper, follow along as I create more content to help you in your weight loss journey.